Now, before we connect this, we need to install the drivers from Roland.com. By the way, this video is not sponsored. Anyhow, I just played it myself because I wanted a better audio interface than I had right now. On the website, we go over here to support, and then we go to updates and drivers. And then on this page, we just scroll down to see if we can find a BridgeCast one. There we are. Click on it. We need to download the BridgeCast one USB driver. Now, I'm using Windows 11. If you're using something else, just download that one. Read the entire end user license agreement. I agree to it and press download file. Then in your downloads folder, we have a zip file. Just extract it right here. Open up that folder and then open up the setup. Then we press on next. Next. There we go. That's it. Installation has been completed. Then over here, we go back to the previous page. And then we download over here the BridgeCast app version 4.3 for Windows. Then we scroll past all the update history. Very nice. I'm going to agree with it and press download file. Then again, we have received a zip file BridgeCast app. Just extract it over here. Open up the folder. They didn't save any space with zipping this file, but hey, who cares? Let's start it up. And we press on install. That's it. Now we can connect this bad boy to our PC. Now this recording is with my new Roland BridgeCast 1 with all these things enabled. Let me show you around this BridgeCast 1 app just a little bit before you start playing with it yourself. What I really like is this option, the mic setup, because when you go to the mic cleanup, you can see that we have the noise suppressor, compressor, de-esser, low cuts, and also over here we can change the EQ. So we now have plus 5, plus 6, plus 2 to give this more this bass inside of my voice. So I can just use this program for live meetings, but also live streaming. I don't have to add any more filters to, for example, an OBS. So this works really great. And it's amazing that it's because of this small hardware system, it all works. But if you're not that experienced with all these levels and attacks and releases, you just go to the mix setup. Choose the right mic. This is a dynamic microphone. And then we just press on mic rehearsal. You need to follow the instructions, but the first thing to do is do not speak into the mic during this measurement. So we're just gonna click on start. All right, well done. Now we need to speak up into the mic with our usual volume. Oh, it's already done. It's finished. So we press on next now. Then we need to speak softly into the mic. Measurement is already finished. Well done. Now we click on next. Check the monitor sound with headphones while speaking into the mic. And of course, we can change it with this button over there and it will just work the way it should. Press OK. Well done. Now everything's been set up. If we now go to the mic cleanup, it just automatically changed the noise suppressor, the low cut, and the compressor over here to get the best sound out of your microphone and your system. Then also a very nice feature is the voice transformer. It's a physical button on your Roland BridgeCast 1, so you can activate this and things just really start weird. And here we go. We also have the
maximum reverb, the high voice, and of course we
also have the fat voice, and then we have the super low voice. So this is really nice.
We can also do this easily with the system itself. You just go over here to the voice transformer, tap it once, it will be activated. But when you press and hold it, you can change which one you want to have. The first one, the second, the third, the fourth, of maybe the 5. And when you release it, it's not been activated, but when you
press on it, it has been activated. So this is really nice.
All this calculation, all this changing is done on the Roland BridgeCast 1 hardware device, not in the software. And that will save some for you guys with this low CPUs and low memories. It will change something. So let me show you right now when I click on this voice transformer,
you can see absolutely nothing going on with my processor or my memory. It just
stays exactly the same because it's all being done inside of this hardware box. That's really nice. If you want to change the place of this one, you can just click on one, press on write, and then you can change it to another one, change the name, or whatever you want. You can also reset it, save the file. You can also load files, so you can load different kind of voice transformers from other people. You can also connect the BridgeCast 1 directly to your gaming console. It's all possible, and then, well, you can still use a different mic for it, or maybe on your headset. It all works, it's really nice. If you go to game USB, you have also some gaming effects. Now this only works when I enable it, you don't hear anything. This only works with the sound coming from the game itself into the BridgeCast 1, and then the output sound will be changed with this gaming effects. You can also change the color, of course. Then we can change the chat. You can also add in a compressor or a de-esser. Change the output, the delay, where is the line out mode, stream mix, iPhones, also all these things. Now what's also a really nice feature is over here you have different kind of profiles for, well, if you're just changing your, maybe you're now streaming, but the entire setup of all these settings will change. Finally, we have the system where you can change the LED brightness of the LEDs on my device. The indicator type, you can change the level or the meter. I would like the meter because then you can still see if I'm not talking too loud or my system is just having too much gain inside of it. Then we can have the mute display. You can let it blink or just turn it off entirely. Also change the phone game. And finally, we have the BGM Cast. When you have registered your BridgeCast 1 and you want to have some free background music and sound effects for your live streams, it's royalty free, so you don't need to worry about copyright strikes. That's really nice. So we press on next. We need to sign in with our Roland account. And we read all these terms of use, of course. And then we press on accept. And of course, they have a paid plan so you can use thousands of royalty-free music titles. Well, I'm gonna stick with the free plan for now. Here on the background music, you can change the mood. So what do you want? I want to have epic, for example. Let's go with cinematic. And then we can just play the music. I don't really understand this part of the app. It seems that there should be a list over here with all the pop music with the happy mood over there. And then we can create also a playlist. That's the way it should work, but it's not in here. So maybe they just have to update it. I don't know. And sound effects. Ooh, I like this one. We have the button press, the elements, impacts. Well, these are pretty nice. Now, and these sound effects can be added to the mute or assign buttons on the BridgeCast 1. So when you just hold it down, you will play a sound. And if you just tap it once, it will just pop in there. You can change it with the shut options and change the level of it. What I also like about this is that this manual is actually an interactive website. So here we can learn everything about the BridgeCast 1. So if you still have any question, it's all in here. So you can just know how it works. Now let me explain this to you when you are streaming a game, for example, when using OBS. To do that, just right-click on your sound and go to the volume mixer. Then we can see that my specific game, Days Gone, over there, the sound device should be your speakers or game. Depends on your OS. In my case, it's speakers and my mic should be this one. So this is the way you should determine all your games to use the right BridgeCast 1 system to make it properly work. In this case, I have over here my Shure FM7X, but the source is my device mic BridgeCast 1. So it's basically only using the mic. But if I were to go and stream like a video game, I have to add in a new source, use an audio input capture, and I would use Bridge. There we go. And then the device should be the stream from the BridgeCast 1. Press okay. To mute the entire Shure FM7X channel right now and do everything throughout the BridgeCast 1. But the beautiful part of this, when I start muting my game on my BridgeCast 1, look at this. So the only sound right now that is being put out to OBS in this case is just my microphone and not the game itself. But if I then enable the game sound, there we go. I can also hear myself, my microphone, but also hear the game and I can put it up or turn it lower. Now, when you, for example, want to change the sound of this game, then I just push over here, push to select. This is the chat. This is the game. Now I can change the volume of my game. I could turn it all the way up or turn it all the way down, but my mic stays the same. So this way you can tune every channel from the chat or the game throughout the stream, so you can stream it to, for example, an OBS. So that's really nice. I love this system already. And if I just want to turn it up, or I can use some voice transformer right now. Beautiful. This is now the recording of the Shure FM7X with my old audio interface and the preamp attached. As you can see, the gain is still very low, and when I'm quiet, we hear a lot of noise. This is now the recording of the MV7X with the Bridge Cast 1 audio interface without any preamp, because it's already built in. As you can see, the gain is really good, and when I'm quiet, the denoiser does its job perfectly. I also want to show you the noise suppressor, because what you're hearing right now is the gate type, but we also have the adaptive type. Now this really makes a difference in how the noise suppressing is going on through this Roland BridgeCast 1. As you can see, I still have to play around a lot with all these settings to get the best sound out of my voice, but it's just brand new and I just wanted to put this video out so you guys can decide. If you like the BridgeCast 1, please buy it via my affiliate link inside of the description of this video. I get a very small commission, so thank you very much. Like this video and subscribe to my channel, where I basically only make videos about online marketing, SEO and WordPress. Well, if you ever want to create a website, you're in the right spot, so subscribe to my channel.